Still August 7th, 2023. I am still Solid Blue Sister, and this is still my turn to talk. So welcome, Blunt Ninja, Shelby, Fair Use, Frankie, thanks for coming back. I always know when Podbean's gonna start acting up. Whatever platform you're listening, welcome and thank you. AB, welcome. Okay, so let's get started. Hey, Minnesota, welcome, welcome. Shelby's going live after my show. Shelby, I'm going to try to keep this to an hour. My trip was good. I was actually with Minnesota. I was with Minnesota. Had a really, really good time. Yeah. No plane drama. Was able to listen to Shorty's talent show while I was waiting to board my plane coming back. But it was a good trip. Stopped over in Chicago for overnight to take care of some business and headed on to Minnesota. So anyway, today, you wake up, it is tomorrow. Did you think it wouldn't come? And, I have this topic because, you know, I find it interesting as I get older that people will do things and they think that everything's going to be okay. They got away with something or, you know, things were not working out for them, but it actually does. And you wake up the next day, you know, tomorrow does come. Tomorrow does come, be it karma, be it something that you always wanted and it happens for you. Tomorrow does come. Whatever you've done, whatever, you know, things you wish, tomorrow does come. And it can be a positive or it could be a negative. If you spend your life robbing banks, one day you're going to go into the wrong bank and you're going to get caught. You know, if you spend your time doing good for others and it never seems to come back to you, I believe that one day that it will come back to you. And it will come back to you in your lifetime. It may come back to you the last day that you take breath on this earth. But I do believe that it does come back to you. I, you know, some people think that, you know, that it's silly. But this is what I think. Hey, Lou, you know, I think that, you know, if you put out negative, negative vibes will come back to you. But that's just me. You know, that's why I say, you know, you wake up and it's tomorrow. You know, did you think that it wouldn't come? Did you think that sooner or later something would not catch up to you? Or when it does catch up to you, it's something that you always wanted? Because another thing that I truly believe, I am doing well, Lou. Thank you. You know, one thing that I truly believe in is at least one thing in this world that you want. One thing. And I know we all want a lot of things. Some people want the world. Some people are just happy with just a few things. Some people may only just want that one thing. I think that you will get that one thing if you truly want it. And if they say, how do they say it? If you're living right. You know, if you're living right, I do believe that good things will come back to you. But tomorrow will come. It may be your last tomorrow, but it will come. And no one in this world, unless they kill you, can prevent the sun. Well, put it like this. They can prevent you from seeing the next day, but no one in this world is, no one in this world is God. No one can prevent like people will say, well, you don't make the sun rise and set every day. No one has that power. You know, but tomorrow will come. And whether you believe in God, whether you believe in some other being, whatever you believe in, until the end of days, until God decides that the world has ended, then it won't come. Lou, you want to know people know how to drive. Lou, I am doing a show on driving. Literally, I was thinking about that this morning while I was walking my dog. And I am doing a show this morning because there are a lot of things that just irritate me. So that show is coming. And it is coming. Joey says, never happened. You know, but, I mean, do you guys ever do things or have done things in your life that when things happen, whether it be a negative or a positive, you knew exactly why it happened because you did something or you said something and it came back to you? I mean, there are things that I've done in my life that were a negative. And when something super negative came back to me, I knew exactly why. I knew exactly why it was coming back because I knew what I did, you know, whatever. But also things that I've done. Hey, Gigi, welcome back. Thanks for coming back. You know, also for things that I've done that have been good and positive vibes have come my way, I know why. You know, so Lou, you can call in whenever. You said I'm cursed. Luckily, it's almost over. I don't know, Lou. Do you believe that people can curse you? And if you get cursed, is it because of something that you've done, or is it just because somebody just put a curse, a hex on you? Oh boy! Hey, fair use. Welcome. Yes, I've seen it. Now, I've been to New Orleans a couple of times and I've seen people do curses and what have you. And yes, I do believe in voodoo, and I do believe that how do I want to put this? I do believe people have the power of cursing. I mean, I believe that if someone says something to you, and if you believe it enough of what that person said, it will happen. Let me put it like that. I believe that if someone says, you know, you better be careful because of what you did or whatever, you're going to die tomorrow. I think that you can stress yourself out to a point where you can drop dead, that you can have a heart attack and you can drop dead. You know, fair use, did you want to come up, or was that a mistake? No worries. I believe people can, and see, Blunt says the same thing. I believe people can curse you. I mean, I think that they can. And Lou says, I've seen it done to others. I've seen it so many times. So once again, you know, you wake up tomorrow and someone that you, hey, Hanny J, welcome. What you cooking, Fair? I do believe that, again, that you can say something to someone, or someone can say something to you, or you say something to someone else, and that person believes it so much that it happens. I think that is, I think it's possible that someone says, you're going to, you know, become rich. Unless they're very clear about what rich means, does it mean that you're going to win the lotto and you're going to win $30 billion? Or does it mean that you're going to become rich and you have friends that, you know, that you wouldn't trade for the world? Or your family is like just the most wonderful family ever? Or, you know, you have a job, or, you know, whatever. That's just so, that's something that just makes you happy. I do believe that happens. It's a hard energy to remove. Okay, Shelby. Okay, I'm confused. So I'm cursed. So Shelby, are you saying that Shelby, what are you saying? I don't know what you're saying, girl. I don't know what you're saying. You're gonna have to explain. You have to explain it. You have to explain it. I don't know. Hello, Shelby.
Hello. You caught me eating.
Oh, that's okay.
No, it's Lou and I have been talking back and forth, and it's just something that we have been talking about, I guess. It's just, I didn't mean to put it in the chat. I meant to Discord him.
Oh, okay. All right.
So I'll stay up here on your panel.
No, I mean, if you want to finish eating, by all means, do so. You want?
I can mute.
All right. All right. So, I mean, guys, you know, so do you believe that if you or someone else does something, they will get away with it? Do you believe that if you've done something, and I'm talking about in the negative, no matter how small or how big it may be, that you will get away with it? Do you believe that if you kill someone, and just because you weren't convicted, you got away with it, but does it come back to you some other way? You know, does your business suffer? Do you lose your marriage? Do you lose your friends? If you've been, you know, mean to, your brother or sister, you know, your entire life but when you were younger, and there's that resentment there from the siblings that you've been mean to, does it come back to you when you're older and they've cut off all ties with you? So do you really get away with anything? Do you think that tomorrow's not going to come? Do you think that the negative that people do, that they just, you know, that everything's cool? So while some people may harp on the fact that someone got away with murder, or that teacher, you know, always picks on me, but every time they leave the room is not this person that's doing it, is really that person. And that particular student never gets in trouble. They're always laughing, you know, and they laugh and they make fun of the person that did get it. But do they get it later on? Does something happen where they get it later on? Does that class reunion happen 30 years later, and the person that, you know, you always set up for the fall come up to you and they knock the crap out of you? I mean, I'm just saying. So those are things, you know, that I think about. Shelby, do you want to say something?
I think, excuse me. In certain circumstances, depending on who you are and how bad you were hurt, I think it comes back to them in different ways.
So when you say how bad you were hurt, are you saying that someone who wasn't hurt that bad?
I mean, it depends on the situation and the severity of how you were hurt.
Okay. All right.
Because, I mean, there's like, I'm not saying like, you know, how some people say, well, there's like different ways of, what's the word I'm looking for? There's different tiers of
pain or something.
No, like, I guess, I don't know if you've ever heard of this. Like, here, it's like you have people that talk about if somebody commits suicide, for example. Okay, they talk about, like, like Catholics talk about the different tiers or whatever.
I know that suicide, I'm not Catholic, but I do know that, if I'm correct, suicide is considered a sin.
Right, that's what I'm talking about. Okay. If they have, like, Catholics will say, or it goes something like purgatory or something.
Mm-hmm.
There's like different levels.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh gosh, now I've done lost the train of thought. Lord. But okay, yeah. Okay, so depending on the severity of the action of what the person has done to hurt another person, I think that's how karma gets you. Or if you don't believe in karma, but you believe in other ways of the person getting their just, you know, whatever, however you call it. And yeah, I think people eventually they get their just cause.
Okay, so Shelby, when you say different levels, so does that mean that the school bully always beat up Johnny and bruised him, as right, compared to he would just make fun of, you know, Joe.
Uh-huh.
Didn't touch Joe, but right, he would just make fun of Joe. Doesn't mean that Joe is not hurting in the inside, that his feelings are not hurt, and you don't know how Joe is taking that he's internalizing this, whatever. So are you saying that the school bully will probably get it worse because he actually physically abused someone? happened as opposed to verbally or mentally, that he's going to get it worse because of the physical as opposed to the non-physical?
No, it depends on the person that was hurt.
Okay. So then that means, so at the reunion, I'm just throwing out 30 years, mm-hmm. both Billy and Joe are sitting at this school bully comes back to the reunion. They're not the same person. They're right. completely different. They may be a successful businessman. They can be a billionaire, or maybe they're just a regular old person minding their own business. But mm-hmm. Joe and Billy, you know, they're pissed. They've been holding this in, whatever. So is it justified for them to approach this person, even though this person has changed, for them to go up and, you know, basically tell them what they think and have some strong words or whatever? Would they be in the wrong?
Yes. That's talking resentment. You can't hold resentment. Resentment will cause you to be bitter.
But is it okay? But at the same time, though, is it resentment or is it, or again, I say, is it karma? It's like, this is what I'm saying. So this person, this school bully never got in trouble for anything that they did. So now at this reunion, now it's coming back to you. Now your wife is possibly there with you, you know, whatever. And other people who were in the class, they're kind of just sitting back because they knew how you were, whether or not you've changed, whether or not you've, you know, you've gotten an award for the best person ever, you know, the last 20 years, whatever. But in school, this is what you did to me. So does that person have a right for you to, well, tomorrow's here, dude, and I just want you to know this is what I think?
No. Uh-uh.
Okay. That's where I'm going to have to. That's where I'm
going to. I mean, that's it. That's like 30 years of, I mean, that's, I'm, uh-uh, you should.
Okay, Shelby, then let me put it like this. Going back to the Catholics, going back to Catholic priests who have molested children.
Yeah.
Maybe 30, 40 years later, and these children are grown. Is it resentment or is it karma? Do they not have the right to be upset for what you did to me in the past?
Now, see, that's a totally different issue.
Okay, and even if this, let's say this priest, you know, they've repented, they stopped doing it, say they stopped doing it 20 years ago, but 50 years ago, they did it to you. And for whatever reason, maybe you grew up and you can't have relationship with women, or you grew up and you're robbing banks and you got on drugs or whatever because of what this person did to you. Why is that different? Why is it different if the school bully was beating you up? Who's to say that I didn't turn to drugs, or if they were just verbally just talked about, you know, oh, you come to school and, you know, you never have clean clothes or whatever like that. How do you know that I didn't go and, you know, do something to hurt myself or whatever?
Because that's an adult doing something to a child. There's a special God for children.
Okay. So there's a special God for children. Whether or not that school bully was a child, they were still doing something to another child. So does it matter? But does it matter what the crime is? Because technically, if you believe in God, every sin, there's one sin is not greater than
the other. Right.
So every sin is a sin.
Right.
So when you say that it's something done to a child, then you know, can you really say that if you're looking at what the Bible says or what society says? If you look at what society says, then I guess it is different. If you look at what God says, then it is. I know. I gotta throw those variables. Throw those variables that crazy talk about. I'm saying
you're not supposed to pick on me.
I'm not picking on you. I'm just saying, you know, you threw something out there and I caught it and I'm throwing it back. I'm just saying, you know, if no sin is the same. I mean if no sin is different, if everything, if according to the Bible, there's no sin that is greater than the other. But you look at what man has done, murder is worse than, going to the store and robbing 7-Eleven and you get $50. But society says, well, you have to go to jail for that. Where you murder someone, you may go to jail for 10 years for 7-Eleven, but you'll go to jail for life if you murder someone. But you look at the Bible, every sin's the same. So again, why is it different from that bully meeting me 30 years later at a class reunion, and I'm basically telling them to go screw themselves, opposed to that Catholic priest that you molested me 30 years ago, and I'm telling you to go screw yourself? What's the difference?
Okay, and
I'm sorry.
The difference is
you did say you weren't going to stay up on the panel. So anyway, go ahead.
The difference is, okay, no adult, period, has a right to touch a child in any shape, form, or fashion that the child is not comfortable with. For one. Okay? The difference between that is when the children were little, it was just words. Words hurt. I know. Been there, done that. Okay? The adult touched. Okay? Yes, that's demeaning also. But that's a different kind of screwed up.
But Shelby, is it really? Because again, what about that bully that physically beat up that other classmate? What about that school who beat up? So that person did touch. So then, okay, then let me put it like this. Would it be a difference if you had the priest or whomever molest the child when they were younger, 30 years goes by, 40, whatever, and they see that person, as opposed to what about an adult who raped another adult? Is there a difference in terms of karma? Is it resentment or is it karma that now I'm face to face with you and I'm either going to tell you to go screw yourself or I may do something worse because what you did to me affected me. Doesn't matter what it was, you affected me.
There's no difference in that.
Okay.
I mean, when you're adult, I mean, when you're a child, yes, it's going to affect you. You know, right, yes. When you're an adult, either way, you're going to be out of your mind. And you're going to do things that you're not proud of. One of those things, 9 times out of 10, as an adult, you're going to think, okay, this person has done this to me. My only other option is to kill them. They don't, you know, they don't see the, I don't know.
No, I mean, no, I understand what you're trying to say. I understand that, but I guess this is when I say you wake up and it's tomorrow, that people who have done wrong to other people, do you think that you've gotten away with it for so long that even if you've changed your life and you run into that person in the street and you don't know, like I said, you don't know what your actions have done to this person. People looking on the outside may think, oh, all they did was call you names, or all they did, oh, he saw what he hit you a couple of times. That was, you were in.
Right.
So I'm saying, So should this person be shocked that this person that they have not seen possibly in all these years still hold the resentment? Because I don't care. You may not think it's a big deal. You may have changed your life. You may be the best person ever. But back then, it wasn't funny. It wasn't funny to me. You know, I wasn't laughing. You hurt my feelings. You hurt me. You did whatever. You know, for a long time, I had to go see someone, and I, you know, I had to pay for that. And I mean, just so many things. So when karma comes around, that's why I say, is it resentment is it you being resentful, or is that person getting karma? Is did tomorrow come for that person? And whether I resent you or not, karma has come back your way, you know. Or as Malcolm X said, the chickens have come home to roost, and now you have to listen. You have to listen.
Well, yeah, I mean, either way, you're gonna have your cuss. I mean, either you get it here and up there, or wherever. You know, everybody believes different, but I mean, you're gonna get it here, and then your afterlife, you're gonna get it then too.
Okay. And Fair You says, I think all those checks get cashed and sorted out on your way out and on your way in. That's interesting. Lou says, karma usually hits you when you're high. Minnesota says, damn. You know, I mean, because I do believe in karma. I do believe that the things that people do, it may not come back to you, you know, that day, next week, whatever, next year. But I do believe, especially if you do something bad, or something that's just not right. And it, like Blunt says, karma affects everyone. I do believe that sooner or later, you're going to get yours, and you're going to know why.
Right.
You know, and if you don't, know why, then that school bully who beat me up, you know, when I find them and, or I run into them and I just look at him, just triggers me, and I just sock him, whatever. They say, what is this for? I'm going to tell you why. Because in sixth grade, this is what you did to me. Or third grade, this is what, you know, this is what you did. You know, right. And I have heard of people going to class reunions, or hell, even funerals, where people have gone and they were like, you did this to me, and you did this, and when we were in school, blah blah blah. Or at funerals, I have seen them, you know, when the person's gone, it's like they were this. Why everybody's like, oh, so and so was the nicest. No, they weren't. They did this, and they did that, and did this, and they just, and you know, and those people just let it all out. And then some people say, well, they shouldn't have done that there. They should. Well, why not? Because it was a funeral.
Well, I can certainly say, in this standpoint, you know about the situation of our family. Okay, well, to make this point short, we're just like biding time. My mother-in-law is not in the best of health, and my daughter has already made it pointedly clear that if and when my mother-in-law passes, she's not going to stand idly by. She is going to let the person that has hurt me throughout the duration of my marriage know just exactly how she feels about her. So, you know, it's like this situation. It's kind of like the same situation, because you got to look at it this way. You're picking on one person, and that one person is strong enough to go home, say their kids, and they go home and they tell their parent. You've basically hurt that entire family.
Mm-hmm.
So in my case, yes, I'm a grown woman. I should be able to, you know, fight my own battles, per se. But I'm not the type person that does that. I kind of like hold everything in. And I let people run over me and blah, 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 blah. Okay. My daughter, on the other hand, she is very strong-willed. She is just like my passed away father-in-law. She won't let people run over her, and she doesn't want people running over us. And I'm one of the people that she doesn't resent the fact of how I am. She resents the fact that I never stood up for myself. So she feels in her heart of heart that when that time comes, and they've already stipulated, you know, my kids have already talked to each other. And if something was to happen to me and they try to come to the funeral. No, they're not letting them in.
Okay. All right. So is that karma or is it resentment? So how would you define that? Is it that karma is now coming around to these people?
I don't know really how to define that, because it's one of those situations to where, you know, they always put up a front, right? Everybody in town thinks that they're this perfect people, that they don't do any wrong, that they're, you know, they are, the best Christians around, and, you know, they care about everybody, but they don't know what goes on, you know, behind closed doors within the family, right? So my kids intend on letting that known. So would you call that karma or would you call that resentment?
I think it's a little bit of both, but I do believe that it's karma. I do believe that sooner or later, whatever you do, whether it's good or bad, when it comes back to you, it can come roaring in where everybody hears you, or everybody hears it and sees it, and it's out there in full mass. Or it can come back to you very quietly, whatever, where only you know. But I do believe that karma is coming back. And if your daughters choose, or whomever, choose to say something to whomever on a particular day at a particular time, I think that's karma. I think that, I think that, well, I don't know. I was just going to say, I wasn't sure if I should say this or not, but I'm going to go ahead and say it. You know, I'm not the type of person that will let things slide.
Right?
You may think I have let things slide, and there are people, you know, and I can name them on one hand, people who that, yeah, you know, she thinks that I'm this, or she thinks that I did this. And I'm like, I know exactly what they did. I know exactly what they've done. And, you know, sometimes I call them out, or sometimes I just wait and call them out at just the right time. But I am that person, you know, I will call you out. Because I believe that, you know, sooner or later, like I said, things are going to catch up with you. You may think that, like that serial killer who's been killing for 30 years. And see, Lou, now I'm talking about serial killers. you know, that's that serial killer that's been just been getting away with it. Sooner or later, they get caught.
Right.
Sooner or later, they get caught. Sooner or later, they do something that they get caught, or they may not know that, you know, that while they've been doing all this stuff, that someone's been watching them for the last 10 years, or someone's been doing this. I mean, you just don't know. Just don't know. And I believe that, is it resentment? Is it revenge? No, I think it's time that, whether it be that child molester, that school bully, that boss on the job that just treats all his employees like shit, sooner or later, you're going to run up against that person who's going to say, screw you, you're not going to talk to me like this, or, you know, you got away with this, and this is what I'm just going to, you know, curse you out in front of everybody at the reunion. Or if I bump into you on the street, I just may take out a gun because you just trigger me, and I shoot you dead.
Right.
You know, you look at some of these school shootings where some of these kids that were bullied, you know, is it karma? I mean, no, you should not go and kill someone. You absolutely should not. And if you're going to kill somebody, please kill the person that you're targeting. Just don't shoot everybody just because everybody's there. You know, right. But I'm just saying, you don't know what's going to trigger one. And while you're doing all this, and that's why I say to parents who have those children that are bullies, or if you're that adult bully, or if you're that person who, you know, you want to, you know, be hateful and what have you, you don't know what someone's going to do. So karma is going to come back to you some way or somehow.
Right.
So, and that's why I say, did you think that it wouldn't come? Did you think that, you know, you, like I said, you wake up and it's tomorrow. Today may be your day of karma.
Right.
You know, or then again, you know, if you've been doing good your in entire life, I do believe that things, you know, will come back to you. And Lou says, always do good deeds with no expectations. But unfortunately, Lou, you have those people that expect something. So Shelby, right. let me ask this. Do you think people who do good things and expect something, as opposed to people who just do good things because it's just the right thing to do, or that's just the type of person they are, do you think the people who expect things will never get anything? You know what I mean? Like, they'll never...
Like they do good deeds, but they think they have something in return from the good deed?
Right.
Is that what you're saying?
Right. And it's like, okay, so you're doing all these great things, whatever, and I'm like, well, dang, you know, Shelby, you know, why is all this stuff, this good stuff happening to Shelby and nothing's good coming my way? Is it because I expect it? Do you believe that the people who don't expect things end up with the things, and the people who expect things end up with nothing?
Yes, I believe that.
Okay. Okay.
And to add to that, I'm not a Bible thumper, y'all. don't take it the wrong way. But it does say in the Bible that to worship in deeds and the quiet or something around that, along that lines,
mm-hmm.
and you're rewarded publicly or something along that line.
Okay.
Is that true?
Okay. All right. I mean, I know what you're talking about, because I do believe that, you will be rewarded.
Yeah.
Do you believe that, now this is getting deep into the Bible. Do you believe that when people say you'll be rewarded in heaven?
Do I believe that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, I just don't understand the where it states something along the lines of, how is it worded? Like something about, like, I don't know. I guess you put it like neighborhoods, I guess. I don't know. I just don't understand that part. Like, how far away are you going to be from God if you committed this sin? Or how far away are you going to be? You're going to be in the, you know, you'll be in the same garden, but you know, how far away are you going to be living?
But are you going to be living far away if God says that every sin is the same? So whether you, or does it matter whether, does
See,
it
that's what I,
okay, so, okay. So then when you get to heaven, does it matter if you've repented or not, or will you, and I'm not talking, I'm just saying, do you repent? Like, will you get to heaven if you don't repent, or if you don't repent by the time you get to heaven, then will you be living further away? Will you be living in bungalow number two as opposed to bungalow number one? Because, you know, I mean, I'm just saying, you know, so.
But I look at it this way. If you're not saved, repenting is not doing you any good.
Well, that's true. That's true.
Because, I mean, it does say that, you know, your prayers are not heard.
Right.
You know, not that, you know, but I mean, I'm not Catholic, I'm Baptist. You know, there's no intercessor there. I mean, Jesus is your intercessor. He prays for you daily, right? But mm-hmm. Catholics believe that you have to go to a priest, ask for forgiveness. And I don't believe in that, you know.
Okay, so let me ask this, and I'm changing this up a little, because you just said going to a priest asking for forgiveness. Can a priest that has done bad things, and again, I'm not Catholic, can they absolve you from your sin if they've sinned? Like, how, because with, and no offense to anybody on this panel, if you are Catholic, but there's just so many things about the Catholic religion that I just disagree with. Because number one, I think, why should I confess to another human being? Why can't I just go to God? Why can't I just get on my hands and knees? And, you know, it's like, why do I need to go to another human who sins, as opposed to me just saying, hey, God, you know, hey, can we talk? You know, and then Blunt says, I believe so, but I have a hard time, going to Father Pete, and he's been molesting all these people, and I'm supposed to come to you. I'm supposed to confess my sins to you? No. No, I'm sorry. I have a huge problem with that.
Mm-mm. And another thing, on Catholic religion, I'm sorry.
I know. Now we are.
I'm so sorry.
Sorry. So,
we're not trying to beat Catholics up. I'm just wondering, okay? You go to a priest to ask for forgiveness, right? Okay. Now the priest has got to pray too. Do they go to another priest? How does that work?
I mean, how does that work? And what if the other priest is doing the same thing that Father Pitt's doing? I'm just saying, because it just doesn't make sense to me. And this is where, when I look at things like repentance and karma and faith, and you know, things that come back to you, it's like, you know, who is the person who has the final say so? I mean, you can do something, go to court, you know, get on death row, and they kill you. You know, but is it really over? Is it really over, or is there more coming to you? Do you still know you're dead? Is there more that you still have to
do? I believe so.
Yeah, so
I believe that it does, because I mean, you have to get judged. I mean, you're judged by man, yes, but you have to get judged by God also. God is a just God, and he's a jealous God. I mean, you're going to commit the sin. You're going to have to pay the consequence.
So, Shelby, let me ask this. I'm asking you because you up here. You said you want to stay. So, let me
Might
ask
as well.
Do you think that people in the last 10 years or so, maybe 20, whatever years, have fallen further from God, that they question God more? Like, is there really a God, as opposed to, because I hear a lot of people, and you know, even within my own circle, people will say I'm atheist, I don't believe in God. You know, because they question, you know, how can I believe in something that I can't see? But then again, they say, well, you're supposed to have faith. You know, and then again they say, well, the Bible says this. But the Bible is so old, it's like, who really wrote the Bible? Again, because something says, and you know, you understand what I'm saying. Do you think that people have fallen further, and everything that's been going on with the Catholic Church, with this reverend over here who has all this money, he has this mega church, and this pastor over here, and you know, whatever. Do you think people have fallen further away because, you know, the church has just become
screwed up?
I prefer to use the word corrupt. They are corrupt.
Well, yeah, corrupt. Yes, I believe so. But, okay. You know, I think it just all leads up to history itself, prophecy itself. We're living in the last days, whether you believe that or not, whether you believe in God or not.
the last days are going to take. God's timing is not our timing. You know, we think it could be tomorrow, right?
Mm-hmm.
God's timing could be another 100 years. You know, we don't know. Only God knows when he snaps that finger. Go get my people. You know, I believe that the world is going to get worse before things get better. With the stuff that's going on here in America, it's going to get hugely worse. I believe before the time comes, there will not be an America. We will be a foreign country.
Okay. All right. Because one thing that I've thought about with, you know, all the fires and the floods and the hurricanes and the tsunamis that are going on, are we going to have another Noah's Ark type thing where, you know, everything's covered in water, everybody's gone, just a chosen few. And I think the people who think they're chosen are not the chosen ones. You know, it will be just very, very few people, if any. But we'll all just, you know, that, you know, we will have another flood that just comes and just wipes everything out, and you start over. And that's why I say, you know, again, going back to the title, you wake up and it's tomorrow. I think, you know, what happens if, you know, it starts raining this winter and it doesn't stop. And it's just raining everywhere. And we're having floods and we're having this, and this is washing away, and it doesn't stop. I mean, or what if it snows? And I mean, because the weather is so screwed up all over the world. It is so screwed up, whether you believe in climate change, whether you don't, whatever you believe. I truly believe, like you said, I think we are nearing end of days. How is going to happen? I don't know, but I think we have signs. I think we have signs.
The weather is a sign. Because you don't know, he's coming like a thief in the night.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know if it's going to be winter. You don't know if summer. You don't know if it's going to be raining. You don't know if it's going to be snowing. You don't know. You honestly don't know. That's why the weather is screwed up, in my opinion.
Well, you know, you have people out there who are telling people, you know, be careful. You should be, you know, be warned, whatever. But I do believe that people don't listen. And that's another thing. I do believe that if people are saved, I think it will be the ones that truly listen, the ones that truly look around and see what is going on. That you take politics and throw it to the side. You take religion to a certain point and you throw it to the side, because religion to me has become a joke for some people. You know, they use it to further their own agenda. And I think that those are the ones that are going to be, you know, won't be on the ark, you know, so to speak, you know. But I do believe that, you know, there will be a few that are left standing, and it'll be the ones that truly believe and truly understand what is going on. And I think we're at that point. I think that in some cases, maybe we've already been chosen. I don't know. I can't say whether I'd be on the boat or not, whether it's an airplane. I don't know.
Right.
You know, but I do believe in karma, and I do believe that we need to realize that if tomorrow comes, we need to be prepared what tomorrow brings, because every day you wake up, it's something.
There's something going on.
There's something going on, whether it be good or bad, it's something. Something going on.
If you hadn't noticed, when you're little, or when you are little, or our generation, you know, days took forever to go by. Now it's like, you know, you're
you just cut out, Shelby.
Can you hear me now?
Yes. Okay. Yes. You cut out when you said that our generation now it's
okay. For our generation, when we were kids, it was like it took forever for a day to go by, right? Mm-hmm. Now it's like as we're adults, I don't know if it's like that for the kids now, but it's like it seems like you're up more than you are asleep, so days go by so much quicker. It's like you blink and it's Friday.
Yeah.
It's, you know, you are awake on Monday and then you blink, it's Friday. You know, yeah. I mean, it's just, to me, it just shows, you know, if they're going to keep, it's going to get to where there's, it goes by faster and faster and faster also. So, you know, it's just, it's all in what you believe. It's all in how you interpret, and it's all in how you handle every day that comes to you.
Well, I do say that those people who have done things in the past, whether it be bitterness on the person who was grieved, or karma coming back to the person who did the harm. I think the people who do harm, they need to watch out, because, you know, you don't know what someone's trigger point is. And I think that the world as a whole, we've triggered a lot of stuff, and yeah, it's time for us to pay the piper. And there are a lot of things that I did not think that I would see in my lifetime that I have. Right. And I think that end of days is one thing that I will see. I think that very well may see the end of the world.
Yeah.
So I don't know if I'm going to burn up.
If not,
whatever.
If not, I will be very surprised if we don't.
Okay.
I'm very surprised.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm just trying to make it to 100 plus one day. Like, I would like to enjoy my birthday. I mean, I can die at 12:01 after my birthday, the day after my birthday. But I would like to. I am so serious, y'all. I so want to make it to 100. I really, really do.
We may do it.
Well, I mean,
tell.
This is true. You know, I was you know, thinking about, you know, how long people live, and you know, you have some people who, you know, live to, you know, like Jimmy Carter, he's like what, 97? He's gonna be 98. You know, the man has had so many health issues. He just may make it to 100. I mean, you never know, you know. But then you have those people who, you know, only make it to their 10th birthday, or the mother who recently, I think this last week, I think she was a doctor. Was she a doctor? The one who killed her newborn and then killed herself.
I heard about that.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. I can't remember if she was a newborn or if she was an attorney, but I'm a newborn. If she was a doctor or an attorney, but she killed her newborn and then she killed herself. But, you know, I mean, you just never know how much time you have on this earth. You can go out tomorrow and get hit by a car. You know, right. You know, you can have cancer and live for the next 20 years. And right, the person who's seemingly healthy, they die in 5.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I do believe that we should live each day as if it were our last. And I really try to, even though there are some days where I've just, you know, it's like this cannot be happening. I really do try that when I do close my eyes at night and hoping that I wake up, you know, and pray that I wake up the next morning, that I ended my day on a good day.
Yeah.
You know, I have learned to stay away from people that I argue with, because they're a waste of my time. They're right, a waste of my time. They're not worth it. And they make my time on earth less pleasant.
And shorter.
And shorter, yes. Yes. You know, they add stress. So, you know, I try to, you know, just in engage and do things that are going to make me smile, that are going to, you know, make me happy.
The ones you love.
Yes, yes. You know, but constantly dealing with people, you know, yes, I have clients and customers that it's like, oh my God, seriously.
Right.
You know, but even then, you know, I end that phone call or whatever, like, you know what? You have a good day.
Good day.
You know, you whatever.
Right.
So y'all, I'm just saying that, you know, if tomorrow comes, let it be a good day. Let it be something good. Let it be something positive.
Right.
So anyway, Shelby, I am going to, I said I was going to keep this to an hour. So I'm going to end it now. Do you want to tell anybody about your show or when your show is coming on, or are you coming on in 5 minutes, 10 minutes?
Give me about say 5 minutes and then I'll be on. It is a update on a show from yesterday. Lou Rock and Shorty are on a bet. Shorty is not allowed to say anything bad, mean, or upsetting to anyone for 24 hours. They started at 9 o'clock, which was 10 o'clock their time last night, and they have to go until 10 o'clock tonight.
Okay, wait. So Shorty's going to be on your show?
She's supposed to be, yes.
Okay,
ma'am.
So that means that I can say something and try to goad her?
No, we are not allowed to goad them, but...
Okay, all right. See, I wasn't on the show yesterday, so I don't know. So, okay, all right.
There is going to be a topic at the top of the chat that they have to debate.
Okay, all right.
And they can't, but they cannot, you know, they can't go to their old ways. They have to debate it clean.
So, I take it, are there going to be people allowed on the panel?
Yes, there's can be people on the panel, and you can comment in the chat, but you cannot, agitate them.
Oh man. Okay.
So actually give me about 10 minutes.
Okay. All right. Yeah. And Blunt says, I want to go out with a bourbon in one hand and a blunt in the other. Girl, I'm feeling you. So, all right, y'all. So, Shelby is coming back in 10 to 15 minutes, and I'm going to go out with one of my favorite songs, which I like to play, Nightingale, Nora Jones.
Nightingale, sing us a song of a love that once belonged. Nightingale, tell me your tale. Was your journey far too long? Does it seem like I'm looking for an to a question I can't ask? I don't know which way the feather falls. If I should blow it to the left. Nightingale, sing us a song of a love that was your journey far too long? All the voices that I spin around me, trying to tell me what to say. So can I fly right behind you can take me.
And that's it, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your day. I will be over on Shelby's show. You guys over there. And hopefully I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.